Hello friends, welcome to PharmDpedia. As we have discussed the introduction about hypertension, let us discuss about diagnosis and management of hypertension in this video. First, diagnosis of hypertension. The best way to diagnose hypertension is to measure blood pressure with sphygmomanometer. Coming to the treatment, it is a pharmacological way in which antihypertensive drugs are used. They are classified as follows: diuretics, calcium channel blockers, angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, beta blockers, angiotensin II receptor blockers, vasodilators, direct renin inhibitors, alpha blockers. Here is a flowchart representing the antihypertensive drugs. These antihypertensive drugs are classified to diuretics, renin angiotensin system inhibitors, sympathetic inhibitors, calcium channel blockers, vasodilators. These diuretics are further classified to thiazide diuretics, high saline diuretics, potassium sparing diuretics. RAS system inhibitors are classified to angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, angiotensin receptor blockers, direct renin inhibitors. Sympathetic inhibitors directly classified to four subtypes: beta adrenergic blockers, alpha plus beta adrenergic blockers, alpha adrenergic blockers, central sympatholytics. Calcium channel blockers are classified to phenyl alkylamine derivatives, benzothiazepine derivatives, dihydropyridines, and these vasodilators are classified to arteriolar dilator, arteriolar plus venodilator. We can see many drugs here classified accordingly. Now let us discuss about each class particularly. Diuretics. Loop diuretics are high efficacy diuretics. They prevent sodium and chlorine ions absorption in loop of Henle. Example, furosemide, that is 2280 mg per day is administered. Glucose intolerance, hyperlipidemia, impotence are the adverse reactions involved in loop diuretics. Thiazide diuretics. These are a medium efficacy diuretics. They inhibit sodium reabsorption at the beginning of distal convoluted tubule. Example, chlorothiazides, 12.5 to 25 mg per day is given. Hypokalemia, hyperuricemia, hypomagnesemia are the adverse reactions involved in using thiazide diuretics. Coming to potassium sparing diuretics, these are the low efficacy diuretics. They prevent excessive loss of potassium at distal convoluted tubule. Example, amiloride, 5 to 10 mg per day is suggested. Gynecomastia is a common adverse reaction of potassium sparing diuretics. Calcium channel blockers. Here is a short way to remember the calcium channel blockers' action and side effects. The calcium channel blockers include verapamil, nifedipine, diltiazem. The mechanism of action of calcium channel blockers is to block calcium channels to cells, which results in the decrease of contractility and conductivity of the heart muscle, which leads to demand for oxygen. Amlodipine, 2.5 to 10 mg per day is given. Constipation, dizziness and headache are the adverse reactions of calcium channel blockers. Angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors. These drugs ends in pril suffix. Example, captopril, enalapril, benzenapril. The mechanism of action of angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors is to lower peripheral vascular resistance without increasing cardiac output, cardiac rate and cardiac contractility. Captopril, 12.5 to 150 mg per day is suggested. Hypotension, dry cough, rashes, hyperkalemia are the adverse reactions found in using of ACE beta blockers. Here you can see the mechanism of action of beta blockers. Decreased activation of beta receptor of heart leads to decreased cardiac output, which automatically leads to a decrease in blood pressure. These beta blockers, the drugs ends with the suffix lol. Example, atenolol, which is given 25 to 100 mg per day. Bradycardia, fatigue, lethargy, insomnia are the adverse reactions involved in beta blockers. Angiotensin II receptor blockers. The name itself indicates that these drugs block angiotensin II receptor, which is responsible for the aldosterone secretion. The blockage of aldosterone secretion leads to decreased sodium and water retention, which automatically lowers the blood pressure. These drugs ends with the suffix sartan. Example, losartan, which is 50 to 100 mg per day is suggested. These drugs are phototoxic. Dry cough, rashes, hypotension are the adverse reactions involved. Vasodilators. Vasodilation of blood vessels allows the blood to flow easily and causes the blood pressure to drop. Example, minoxidil, 10 to 40 mg per day or twice a day is suggested. Tachycardia, nausea, vomiting, arrhythmia, precipitation of angina are the adverse reactions of vasodilators. Direct renin inhibitors. Renin inhibition leads to the widening of blood vessels, making it easy for the blood to flow. Example, aliskiren, 150 to 300 mg per day is suggested. These are phototoxic and causes diarrhea in higher doses. Alpha blockers. These alpha blockers block the hormone noradrenaline from tightening the muscles of the walls of small arteries and veins. It causes the vessels to remain open and relaxed and thus improves blood flow and lowers the blood pressure. Example, doxazosin, 1 to 8 mg per day is suggested. Reflex tachycardia, first dose syncope are the adverse reactions involved in alpha blockers.
We have gone through the treatment of hypertension. Let us have a look into the non-pharmacological way of treating hypertension. This high blood pressure is controlled by exercise, nutrition and vitamins. And hypertensive patients should take less salt and avoid alcohol or fatty foods, lose weight and regular exercise, quit smoking, manage stress, no oral contraceptive pills, no red meat, drinking lime juice, fruits and vegetables intake, vitamin C, mineral, medicine to lower very high blood pressure. And the complications of hypertension include kidney damage, atherosclerosis, heart attack, and the increased hypertension in the brain may lead to stroke through hemorrhage. This hypertension also damages the eye by increased reflectiveness, arteriovenous nipping, retinal ischemia, and papilloedema. This damages the retina and finally leads to blindness.
Thank you for watching the video. Please do subscribe, like, share, and comment your suggestions in the comment box. PharmDpedia.